That was something that he did well. Out centre forward today, from, you know, released from the corner a little bit, and you know that's a good puck out from Cusick to Cousin, and he angled the ball in. That's something that they haven't been doing. He angled the ball in very well there to Paddy Sullivan, missed it, and when Izaki got it, he was patient and he put Niall McCarthy through, who did brilliantly there for that goal. So Cork were doing, you know, they did good things like that. Against Waterford, they weren't good in that department. But then Ray Ryan, silly free there, coming through the man, and you know this was very wasteful. And if you look at Paddy Sullivan here, when the ball drops in, if you look at him, he'll just come in now in the narrow shot, like he has his hand up in the air, kind of, you know, built away, like, look, what can we do with balls like that? And he's a bit of fault here himself. Really, he should have done a bit better. Should have come back across, like, and stuck that. That was a chance. He did work very hard for it, and then left it after man Liam Watson. Tremendous game at full forward and centre forward, scoring 6 points, and he really, you know, he really put the Cork backs under pressure, and that's one area that they won't be happy with. You know, they were sloppy enough at times, Des. So, you know, they did some very good things, and as you said, right, they did some things poorly. But you know, there was nothing in this for Cork, really. You know, everybody expected them to win, so it was a case, come up to Croke Park, get your business done, and get back now and focus for the semi final.
All right, and the man of the match contenders, Paul.
Yeah, Des. I suppose, you know, there was, in a game like that, there was a couple of you know, performances, particularly for Antrim. I think Liam Watson, a full forward, scored 6 fantastic points from play. Okay, he was a bit close to the line a couple of times in the end, got dismissed, but I think his point scoring was fantastic. Niall McCarthy for Cork, you know, won great possession and finished a goal fantastically as well. He was a threat toward the game. And Tom Kenny in midfield from Cork as well, coming through, picking off some lovely scores.
All right, then. And the award goes to?
Well, we gave it to Niall McCarthy, Des. You know, he was superb in the first half, really. And really, the match was a contest in the first half. And, you know, he did very, very, very well. Linked up very well with his defence and midfield and, you know, took his goal superbly well and, you know, ran away at times and, you know, was very sensible, knocked over a few good points. And, you know, he carries in the form that he displayed in the Munster final and in other matches, right, and the Limerick match right into this one. And, you know, that's why we gave him the man of the match. He was excellent on through the first half, particularly.
All right, then. It was a good finish, wasn't it, Paul?
Oh, yeah. Like, I mean, he realised he was going to be hooked. And, you know, it's something now that players are practising, I'd say. There's like kicking, sometimes it can go sideways. And but I think that it's a very good skill to have. Just throw it out a heady and flick it down. Particularly if you put it down low where the goalkeepers can't have time to react. Yeah, absolutely.
All right, then. Well, let's hear from the man of the match, Carrick Tools, Niall McCarthy.
And Ona Scully of Etihad Airways is presenting Niall with his award. Well done, Niall. You seem to be really enjoying your hurling at the moment.
Not too bad, you know. I suppose last week was a huge disappointment to us, like, you know, but we didn't have much time to think about it. To come back into training Wednesday, get our house in order again, and fellas were already down, like, you know, but Dennis had a good chat with us Wednesday night, and we'd know the chance to pick ourselves up. If we didn't, we were out playing Antrim today, we'd got beat, like, so. I think it was kind of more mentally, more than physically, that the team were tired, like, but, you know, we're absolutely delighted to get over tonight and look forward to a semi-final in 2 weeks.
Yeah, indeed. That's the line-up for the semi-finals. Kilkenny against Cork and Waterford against Tipperary. And if it's anything like the recent meetings between those four counties, we should be in for a fair few fireworks. Yeah, what about, let's ask you about your opposition, not your own semi-finals. Cork against Kilkenny. I mean, Kilkenny are going to be hot favourites, Paul, aren't they, still?
Well, red-hot favourites, Des. I think, you know, their march through Leinster was predictable enough. They played quite well, I think, against Galway without shooting, you know, they had their shooting boots off that day. They missed, I think, it's 17 wides. Cork's, I suppose, the Munster final and the Munster final replay, glad to get today over, but they have 2 weeks now maybe to get the injuries sorted, Shane O'Neill in particular, Sean Oag, and I don't think Gerry O'Connor will make it. But going into against Kilkenny, I think they'll have to, you know, we were talking about earlier, maybe put a couple of men back behind the ball, you know, kind of do what Waterford are doing, maybe, you know, close down the space that Kilkenny can operate in, and kind of, I know you're kind of robbing Peter to pay Paul at one end where the chances may be limited, but I think a low scoring game would be Cork's best bet, but I think to hold Kilkenny for 70 minutes would be a fair achievement, and I don't see it happening.
Right. And Donal, Waterford and Tip, I mean, Waterford had a fantastic victory over Cork, but that's a big win for Tip today.
Big win, Des, and coming in nicely now. They'll be on a big wave. They've done the jobs that they had to do, got through the qualifiers, right? Were woeful against Cork, and they've come back now with a big psychological win against Galway. I don't think they'll be that unhappy that they're meeting Waterford, and I think Waterford will have it all to do again. They'll have to get back up. I think they'll be favourites because they're Munster champions, and you know, when it comes down, you know, Tip will have studied Waterford now. Waterford's tactics are out of the bag, so to speak. So they'll have enough time to prepare to see how they get through this Waterford defence, and you know, I think it's going to be a 50-50 game today, basically, you know.
Yeah, but equally, will Waterford have learned a bit from Tip today?
The game today was so, you know, up and down the field, right? There was very little tactics. It was just hit it up and, you know, try and get it to the man, you know, the man in the most advantageous position if you could. But, like, there was so up and down the field, right? Okay, yeah. Tip will be trying to cut out the mistakes. There was very little that you could say we can exploit this or we can exploit that. So, you know, it will be down to on the day. The bit of luck, I mean, you know, Tip had a bit of lucky, you know, a lucky break today for the goal. And a bit of luck will decide it maybe. But, you know, it is anybody's game, 50-50.
All right, so if I push you, who'll be in the final then, Paul?
Kilkenny will definitely be in it, Des. As I agree with Don, I think the other semi-final is 50-50. It's a complete role reversal of the semi-final in 08, when Waterford, we came through the qualifiers against the Tip, were red-hot favourites, have the Munster champions, and I think the first quarter of an hour that day, Waterford got 5 or 6 points that really rattled Tipperary. Maybe they were looking towards the final, so, you know, the shoe could be underfoot this year, but I think Waterford are focused enough to realise that Tipperary will enjoy playing them, so... Obviously, I'll go with Waterford, but it's going to be a very tough game.
All right, and Donal?
Both semi-finals, does it?
Yeah, well,
I think you'd have to fancy Kilkenny to come through, the Cork game. You know, they've done it all, and I think they've skipped through Leinster really without any physical toll being taken on them. Right. And I think in the other game, you know, it comes down.